You can't go around talking about some,
I'm a black independent woman. Black women do it all by themselves.
And then you're quick and happy and satisfied with living off of someone's wealth and stability. I just don't believe in it. And I don't think it makes sense. Like before I got in a relationship with my boyfriend, I realized like this was literally my problem. Like I would put myself out there as a strong, independent black woman to the point where men would think that they just didn't need to be in my life. They'll be like, well, why do you need me for? Why do you need a man if you're so strong and independent? And that is where the whole strong, independent black woman situation really does hinder us. If we as black women are going to push this whole narrative of hypergamy, we need to like figure out what we're gonna do. Realistically, the reason I think hypergamy is a whole load of BS is because it negates the fact that you should wanna be with someone because you want to be with that person. You should essentially be with someone because you love them and you care for them. But at the same time, that don't mean go and accept the bum. That don't mean go and date a criminal just because you love them. It means go and work on yourself. Go and build yourself, build your worth, build your brand, whatever it is you want to do, and then go out and find your equal and build together. Opinions that people are gonna be so upset about. Make sure you grab your wine, grab your snacks. I already had my cup. I'm feeling a little zooted, and we're gonna get straight into this nonsense. So first things first, this wig is from Her Given Hair. It's really not the best it could be right now, but it shall do for this video, okay? Everybody, I am the Mademoiselle and this is my channel, and today we are going to be talking about hypergamy. Now this is a video you guys have requested for quite some time and I really wanted to gather my thoughts on it. I watched so many videos, asked a lot of people in my real life, and a lot of just like I had to do a lot to actually compile what I really thought about this, okay? So first things first, I think the idea of hypergamy is very outdated. And I also think that it's really detrimental to black women as a whole and very, very detrimental to gender roles as a whole and the idea of feminism and womanism, okay? So let me just clarify. I do not believe anyone should go date a bum, okay? Whether you're a man or a woman, do not go and date a bum. Don't go and date someone that has nothing going for themselves, someone that can't pay their bills, someone that got bad credit, that don't. Okay, so please do not take this video as me saying go for a lower nigga just because you love him. Because I ain't about that either. Okay, let don't pay the bills, and love is not about to lift you out of any type of situation. Neither is a bad attitude, and neither is the idea of dating someone strictly for their money and social status. Hold up! Pause. Did you get your merch?
No.
Why?
See, I was about to. Okay.
Go get your merch right now down in the description or in the pinned comment down below. This is my $1 million melanin hoodie. Got it in a sweatshirt, got it in a t-shirt. We also got other designs, okay? I got some new designs. Make sure you guys head down to the description or in the pinned comment for your special coupon code. Also, make sure you join my throne. It is a The Mafia group chat. Pretty small right now, but we're growing. We're getting somewhere. I'm in there with a whole bunch of other The Mafia members. It's pretty cool. We talk about social issues, personal issues, and a whole bunch of other stuff. So let's get into a little bit of definitions right now. So there's a lot of blurred lines regarding what hypergamy is, okay? Like, I was watching videos and I was just sitting there like, I don't even understand what this person's saying right now because I go by Google definitions. I don't believe in definitions changing over time. A freaking word means a freaking word, okay? So hypergamy is essentially, in simple terms, means dating up. It is the practice of dating or marrying someone of a higher social or economic status. Now with that, there are two other ideologies called isogamy, which is the idea of dating someone of your equal, and hypnagy, or hypnagy, I don't know how to say that one, but yeah, basically is the idea of dating someone of lower standard. This video is mainly going to be surrounded around hypergamy and why I just think it's nonsense. And I think I'm just like an isogamist or isogamy. I think I believe in isogamy because yeah, I guess you'll see throughout this video. Like when I first heard of this, I was like, yeah, it makes sense. You should always have standards. So to be honest, this is not to blur the lines between gold digging and literally wanting better for yourself. When you go and gold dig, that means you ain't got shit and you're literally taking from someone and not giving back. The idea of hypergamy is basically to build a relationship, build a foundation, build a family with someone who is of social and economic value, who can bring value to you as a person. Now, another thing you need to understand is hypergamy is not a one shoe fits all type of situation. Now, some people may see, oh, I'm dating the hood star, okay? I'm dating the trap lord on the block. So now my status has bumped up, that's hypergamy. While some people see hypergamy as, oh, well, I'm dating, you know, CEO executive of Google or whatever, and you know, now I've been bumped up. So that's another thing y'all need to really keep in mind. What's hypergamy to you may not be hypergamy to me. What's hypergamy to her may not be hypergamy to him. So there's very, very different types of definitions in terms of social impact. Like, depending on where you come from, who you are, and what you want to be in life, hypergamy can be very different. Like, leveling up to you is probably not leveling up to me, and so on and so forth. Realistically, the reason I think hypergamy is a whole load of BS is because it negates the fact that you should want to be with someone because you want to be with that person. You should essentially be with someone because you love them and you care for them. But at the same time, that don't mean go and accept the bum. That don't mean go and date a criminal just because you love them. It means go and work on yourself. Go and build yourself, build your worth, build your brand, whatever it is you want to do, and then go out and find your equal and build together. I've always had that type of idea. I don't even accept things from men. Like, my boyfriend does not sit there and like pay for my nails and pay for my phone bill because I'm an able-bodied adult that can do it for myself. I don't ask him to. Like, he'd probably do it if I asked him. I'm sure he would. But to be honest, like, I've just never been that type of person. My parents always raised me to depend on myself, and that's what I've always done. So this whole idea of, oh, I'm just gonna marry up because he make a lot of money is ridiculous. Would money be a great thing, and will it make you a little bit more comfortable? Yes, but in actuality, it will never make you happy. And let's not forget that niggas can divorce you, which, I mean, at that point, you could get spousal support, child support, whatever, and you'll probably be set. But the other ideology is that it will never be your wealth, period. When you marry someone for their money, for their social economic status, it will never be yours. You'll probably get some Louis bags, some Gucci bags out of it, but it will never be yours, no matter how much you try. I mean, you might get some money out of them, but that wealth is not yours. You're not creating generational wealth by doing that. Now, the reason I believe it is outdated is because I believe that this whole new movement of feminism and womanism and equal rights for women, it just doesn't fit. You can't go around talk about some,
I'm a black independent woman, black women do it all by themselves, we the shit, we lit.
And then you're quick and happy and satisfied with living off of someone's wealth and stability. I just don't believe in it, and I don't think it makes sense. Am I saying to go date a broke nigga? Absolutely not. I just believe it is counterproductive and hypocritical to be this, I'm a strong, independent black woman, and then you're literally taking and expecting men or whoever to take care of you as this strong, independent black woman. If you're going to believe in the idea of hypergamy, you have to literally play your part. If you want to believe in this strong ass gender role of the man should take care of me, the man should bring in most of the bread and butter, I don't want to do much of anything, he need to do this, he need to do that, then you need to do your part. Like, what are you offering as a woman to the plate? Like, what are you doing? If you're going to live like that, you have to be able and willing to put on the hat of, I'm gonna cook, I'm gonna clean, I'm gonna take care of the kids, I'm gonna stay home, I'm not gonna do this, that, and the third. Because most men who will pick up women and will take care of women who have this type of ideology expect you to be at home. They expect you to be their cheerleader. They expect you to just be their wife. They don't expect you to be essentially an equal partner, because they believe that you are, like, not less than, but since they're putting in most of the money, it's like the entire dynamic is not the same. You can't be on this strong, independent black woman, I wanna work, I wanna do this, I wanna do that, and then look for a man that's gonna take care of you. Because what happens is, and I've seen this happen to me, like, before I got in a relationship with my boyfriend, I realized, like, this was literally my problem. Like, I would put myself out there as a strong, independent black woman to the point where men would think that they just didn't need to be in my life. They'll be like, well, why do you need me for? Why do you need a man if you're so strong and independent? And that is where the whole strong, independent black woman situation really does hinder us. If we as black women are going to push this whole narrative of hypergamy, we need to, like, figure out what we're gonna do. Because you can't be all masculine, okay? I'm telling you this right now. You can't be masculine, You can't be all, I'm strong, black, and independent, I don't need no man, and then go and rely on another nigga's shit. It just doesn't make sense. I see a whole bunch of black women pushing this idea, saying, oh, black women should practice hypergamy and marry a white man and interracial dating. We're gonna have to break this into parts because there's a lot going on right here. Like, the whole hypergamy and interracial dating is a whole nother story. I am gonna tap into it, but I feel like it's gonna be a whole nother video depending on how this one goes. I just believe that an adult is an adult and adults should do adult things. I don't believe in anyone, and this is not just women. Men do practice this as well. I don't believe any man, any woman, any able-bodied adult should be relying on the idea of I'm gonna find someone doing better than me socially and financially so I can get ahead in life. I just don't believe in it. I believe hypergamy is BS for the simple fact that I believe as an able-bodied adult, you need to do for yourself and find your equal. I believe everyone should further their education, whether that be college or not, because a high school diploma is nothing, especially in the United States when we literally learn nothing. Like, literally, comment down below if you learned something in high school, like, for real, like 10 things. I learned a lot in high school, but I can't name 10 things I learned in high school, okay? Let's be real. Like, I went to college, but you don't have to go to college to further your education. There's other things you can do. I believe you need to further your education. You need to further your financial portfolio, whether that be with stocks, real estate, just making more money, saving more money, whatever the case may be. I believe everyone should build themselves up and then go find their equal. Like, not because of that. If you do want to date a white man, if you do want to date a rich man, a poor man, whatever, let it be for the right intentions. Don't just sit there and date someone just because of their social status, because of their financial status. Be with someone because you truly want to be with them. If you really don't want to truly be with the person, you're literally ruining the foundation of the relationship, and it's genuinely not going to last. I've always been a firm believer in the power of intent. The power of intent is very important in my eyes. Like, I feel like the intentions that you have behind your actions is what determines if it's successful. If you literally go out and do something with the intent to scam, 9 times out of 10, I don't think it's gonna be successful. Now, you guys are probably like, oh, what about all the scammers? Well, I mean, they're probably a dime in a dozen, or maybe they didn't intend to scam. The world may never know. But the point is, I believe that if you have malicious intent in something, if you do not have the pure intent to do good or to have a positive outcome, you're going to get fucked up. Like, your views, your dreams, your aspirations is not gonna work out. Like, the whole dream of you marrying a rich man just because he's rich and you don't care for him and you're gonna wait till he dies and inherit the money is gonna backfire on you really badly. Understand that most of the time, not all the time, but most of the time, if you're going after a man that is like way older, way richer, has his shit together, you're kind of opening, sometimes, okay, sometimes, you're opening the door for that man to mistreat you and not treat you as his equal. You can't want equal rights. You can't want equal opportunity. You can't want equal treatment, and then you literally are sitting on your ass doing nothing, reaping the benefits of being in a hypergamous relationship. And from what I see, a lot of these women pushing this are leading the lives of, oh, I'm independent, I don't need no man, I got 2-3 degrees, I don't need shit, but you know, I need a man that's making 8 figures. It's like, huh, nigga? Like, if you're going to be in that situation, you really gotta be submissive. You have to be willing to literally let your guard down, be vulnerable, be more feminine. And a lot of you guys probably don't agree with me, but that's literally what it is most of the time. I also don't like the idea of hypergamy because I feel like it really pushes unrealistic standards on normal men. I hate a woman that will drag a man just for not being able to do something that she wants and not something that she needs. If you need a bill paid, if you need your hair done, if you wanna go out, if you want nice things, you buy that for yourself because you should be able to do that for yourself as a fucking adult. No one was put here on earth to supply for you but your fucking parent. And your parent is only there to supply the bare necessity, to be honest. So if you're not fucking starving or dying, the whole ideology of expecting a regular man with a regular salary, with regular responsibilities, to literally wait on you hand and foot and literally do everything, like literally from your finances to taking care of you to babying you and basically telling you that you're right all the damn time when you know you're dead wrong, is ridiculous. A standard man, a regular man, is not going to be able to take care of you, your bills, and him and his bills at the same time. It makes no sense. The whole point of a relationship is to build together, is to be together as one, to build up. Not, oh, well, I take, 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 take while you give, 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 give because I'm the woman. because I deserve it, because I'm giving you cootie, because I'm pretty, because that's horrible. And I think that's why a lot of us, especially black women who believe in this, are in that type of situation today. They don't find men that are willing to do that. A lot of men is looking at us like, bitch, where? Like, okay, so y'all want rights? You want to sit on your ass and then you want me to take care of you and you don't do nothing? Like, no. Like, what are you offering? Like, what are you giving? This is probably one thing that I could say I actually agree with black men on, because a lot of girls that think this way have absolutely nothing to offer. They have no personality, no education, no income, no business, no brand, no aspiration, no goddamn hope. But they want the man to have everything while they have absolutely nothing and benefit off of it. If you believe in hypergamy and you're this type of person, this is not what it's supposed to be, okay? Like, I believe in it to an extent because clearly, like, I want to definitely marry someone that's on my level. Like, that's me. I want to marry someone that's on my level. Like, I want you to have a master's like me. I want you to have an education. I want you to have a job. I want you to be, like, open and be able to talk. Like, I have, like, you know, different standards. Like, no one's saying don't have standards, but if you don't have any standards yourself, for yourself, like, literally for yourself, you have no business going to look for someone that can take care of you. That's ridiculous. You're a fucking adult. You should be able to take care of yourself. It is absolutely unrealistic to expect a man to take care of you and your bills when you can't do that for yourself. You need to be able to do that for yourself. The average man just simply can't do that. And it annoys me how, like, an average man, like, say if he really had bills to pay, maybe he had medical bills, maybe he had to help his own family, and it's like, oh, well, he ain't paid to get my nails, and that broke-ass nigga, this bitch-ass nigga. Huh, nigga? He handled his responsibilities. Just because you don't want to help you get your nails done, which is something that's absolutely not 100% needed, is ridiculous. He should be able to feed you. He should be able to pop up if a car broke down. He should be able to be there as moral support for you and your business ideas, you and your education, you and your financial problems in terms of things that you need. But you getting your nails done, your hair done, and all of that extra shit, and he don't want to pay for it, that's ridiculous for you to go and call someone a broke nigga just because they don't want to. No one is obligated to take care of you as a fucking adult. Like, that really annoys me. What really annoys me is when girls in high school do this shit. Like, they really be like, oh, well, he ain't doing this. It's like, bitch, you're like 17. Like, you can't even do that for yourself. How do you expect him to be able to do it? Like, get it together. I blame culture, society, and media for these problems. Because if you really look at it, society is always talking about, oh, well, like, he ain't got no money, or she ain't got no money, like, she ain't shit. Like, the current society bases a lot of things on wealth and money, and that's really not what things are about. Like, you could have so much money and still get declined for a credit card because your fucking expenses are so high. Your debt to income ratio is so high. Like, it's just ridiculous that they, like, people put so much value on money when it has a lot to do with how well-rounded of a person you are, especially when it comes to finances. You could date a millionaire that probably still can't get approved for a loan because he has so many freaking expenses. Like, don't just sit there and see dollar signs and think that, oh, well, he driving a Lambo, he got money. That shit could be rented. That shit could be stolen. Like, it's just ridiculous. Also, have you noticed that, like, these Disney movies in particular always do this whole story of, oh, poor depressed girl ends up finding her Prince Charming who happens to live in a palace. I feel like that's indoctrinating kids. Like, I really do. I feel like it's indoctrinating kids to believe that this is a standard of life. Like, oh, wow, I'm poor, I ain't got much money, I don't come from money, but, you know, if I find my Prince Charming, he's going to lift me out of my problems. Y'all motherfuckers been watching too much Damn Cinderella, bitch. You like 25 plus trying to look for someone to take care of your shit. You need to take care of your own shit. I know there's this idea that women are naturally hypergamous and men are naturally polygamous, which is the idea of having many wives. Bullshit, I don't care. Bullshit, I've never in my life sought after a man because of his money or status. Like, I mean, it's a good bragging, right? But I've never in my life sat there and took money from a nigga. Like, physical money, absolutely not. Unless it was gas money and they were driving my car, because I had a nigga that did that. But other than that, like, that's not something I do. I've never been like that. And any nigga that's ever talked to me or dated me could probably attest to that in the comment section. Like, I don't do that shit. My current boyfriend, I don't do that shit. Like, I would literally rather cut my hands off than ask my man for money. Like, I would get it another way. The whole polygamy thing is also ridiculous. Like, men are natural polygamists. Like, I feel like people just be making shit up and trying to find evidence to back up their personal opinions. If something's your personal opinion, fine, let it be your personal opinion. But don't just sit there and rope everyone into shit saying, oh, well, women are naturally and men are naturally. No, the fuck they're not. Because there's a lot of people, especially in 2020, who do not think this way. There are plenty of men who have no problem committing to the right woman, who is one woman. There are plenty of women who have no problem making their own money and their own income and finding people that match them, or even dating people who are below them in social or financial status and are perfectly happy with them. Do I agree with all of that or disagree with all of that? Quite frankly, I don't give a fuck. My opinion is get it on your own. Do what you want for you and make sure it's for you and don't rely on nobody else. With that being said, let me know what you think about this down in the comments section below. Do you agree, disagree, why or why not? Make sure you like, share, subscribe, do all that, and I'm gonna see y'all next time.